All right, let's take a look at fraction division. Fraction division gives people trouble because of lack of understanding of what that really means. So we're going to start with some visual representation, so maybe it will give you some sense of what fraction division really means. So let's take a look at 4 divided by half. You have 4 items and half a group. In half a group, you have 4 items. How many in one group? So if half of the group is 4, then you're going to have 8 objects in one group. Or another way to think of it would be half. How many halves fit into 4? This interpretation is easier to look at, so let's take a look. So that's what half means. Half means one piece out of 2. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 4 objects, and we want to know how many of these halves fit into these 4. So let's go take a look. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 halves that fit into 4. So 4 divided by 1 half is 8. Another way to think of that would be 8 times what? 8 times 1 half is 4. That was our definition. Here's something we need to look at. We have 4 divided by half. 4 is the same as 4 over 1. Do you think I need to make least common multiple in the denominators? We didn't have to do that for multiplication, but what if you do it? So then you would have to multiply numerator denominator by 2. And then look, 8 halves divided by 1 half, which is the same as 8 divided by 1 and 2 divided by 2. 8 divided by 1 is 8, 2 divided by 2 is 1. Wait a minute, what's going on here? Have you ever seen things like that? So you're making common denominator. Now they both have the same denominator and you're just dividing across. Am I allowed to do that? Most people just think of 4 divided by half as 4 times the reciprocal of half, which is 2, and that'll give you 8. All right, that interpretation people have seen. But now I'm asking you, what if I make common denominator and then just divide across? Because remember, in multiplication, I just multiplied across. So why can't I do the same with division? A division should also be divide throughout. Do you think that works? Let's just do a few more examples and maybe it'll be clear to you. So clearly, if I divide across, it's not going to help me much here because the numbers are not reducible here. But let's take a look at the picture. So here we have one whole. I want to know how many 3/5 fit into 2/3. So let's just see how 2/3 look then. So there's my 2/3. 2 pieces out of 3, right? Do you remember that? 2 pieces out of 3, that's what 2/3 represents. I want to know how many 3/5 fit. Here's 3/5. How many of these? So this 3 pieces, how many of those fit in here? Well, how can we compare? You can't really tell how many of those fit in here. Clearly, one whole, if you just go straight across here, you'll see it's a little over 1 of these fit in. But how do you know exactly how much fits in? So we would have to make them both out of equal pieces, which means what? Make them both out of 15. So let's do that. So let's make 15 here and 15 here. So now that they're both out of same, we can count how many we have here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 of these. How many of these 9 fit in here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's one whole plus one more out of the 9. So 1 1/9 should be our answer. Take a look. So we're going to take that. So that fits completely there. So that's the 9. And that's the second group, but all of this is not part of it, so take that out, just that 1. So 1 1/9, or 10/9 you can think of. It might be confusing to see division in this manner, but if you can understand the visual representation, it will make it very, very easy for you to do it. So 2/3 times 5/3. I have inverted the 5/3, and look what I get. 10 over 9. So it looks like division is the same as multiplying by 5/3. Since we're so familiar with multiplication, then division is not that much different. We just have to remember to multiply by the reciprocal when you have fraction divide by fraction. So in general, then, if you have a over b divided by c over d, then it's the same as a over b times the reciprocal d over c, or then multiply numerator denominator will be ad over bc. Okay? So a over b divided by c over d. Another way to think of it would be a over b over, because that division means over, c over d, which is the same as a over b times d over c. So if you have fraction over another fraction, which is referred to as a complex fraction, then you just take the numerator fraction times the bottom fraction inverted and then multiply it out. Here's another way you can think of it. A over b divided by c over d. If I make common denominator, this is what I was telling you before. If we make common denominator, then can we do this? The answer is yes, you can. And the answer will then be what? Because look, BD divided by BD is 1. AD divided by BC is AD over BC, which is what this is, isn't it? So look at that. Maybe you have never seen this before, but you can divide across just like multiplying across. When you multiply fractions, you can multiply numerators, you can multiply denominators. When you divide fractions, you can divide numerators and you can divide denominators. If you make common denominator, it makes it a little easier. So it's just something that perhaps I thought you might not have seen before. All right, so let's go 288 divide by 12, which is the same as 288 over 12. You already know how to simplify that. Factor everything, make your factoring tree and factor everything, and then what? Divide like terms, right? So 2 to the 5th and 2 to the 2nd will leave you with 2 to the 3rd. 3 to the 2nd over 3 will leave you with a 3. How about that? Same thing. So first thing is to do what up here? Do you remember? Come on, take a guess. What do we do now? Good. Factor. Factor the numerator. And then reduce like terms, right? How about that? We just saw that a little while ago. Square root 3 over square root 2. You just have to multiply top and bottom by square root 2 so that there is no root 2 in the bottom, and that's your answer then. So division is something you've already been working with in many different forms. What about 2 and 1 thirds divided by 3 and a half? Do you remember how we multiplied them? You change it into fractions first and then multiply, so we'll do the same there. So 7 thirds divided by 7 halves. So 7 thirds times the reciprocal of 7 halves, which would be 2 sevenths. And then what? Multiply tops and bottoms. If there's something to be reduced, reduce it. So 7 can be reduced and you're left with 2 thirds. Okay? Now, true or false? I'll give you a few moments to think. The discussion that we've had so far should help you. The question is, can I divide across? Divide here and here. The answer is what? Yes, it's true. So why is it true? Because we can check it out. 25 over 4 divided by 5 halves will be 25 quarters times 2 fifths, reciprocal of this. And then reduce. And you can see you've got 5 halves. Look at that. So it's true, and in general, it's true also. So here it is. So let's do it both ways. This is how we used to do, where you multiply by the reciprocal, or if you divide A divide by C, B divide by D, then it's going to be A over C over B over D. And we just saw how that means multiplying by the reciprocal, which gives you the same answer. Isn't that interesting? So you actually can Just divide numerators and divide denominators. Just like in multiplication, you can multiply numerators and multiply denominators. This is your next video log. Try these on your own.